Tonight, we're digging into the debate over a proposed new arena in Oklahoma City. Early voting on the issue officially began today.
As Fox 25's Grant Palmer reports, Mayor David Holt and the Oklahoma City Thunder rallied at the Oklahoma County Election Board to make a final case to voters.
At the end of the day, it's a really simple question. Do you want to be a big league city? Do you want to have an NBA team? Do you want to have the concerts that we've enjoyed? Do you want this economic impact or not?
That's the question Mayor David Holt is posing to voters as early voting began Thursday regarding whether or not the city should build a new arena in place of the Paycom Center. The proposed arena is estimated to cost at least $900 million, with Thunder ownership pledging to chip in $50 million. But voters like Nabila Rauda think ownership should contribute more.
I just feel like it's an unfair deal. We're being asked to pay 95% of the cost. Usually arenas, the owners will pitch in at least 45 to 50%. We also have a very small tax basis, which means that we're going to have to be paying more per person.
Holt says those pledges that owners in other cities are making just aren't feasible in a market like Oklahoma City.
We're the 42nd largest market, and markets our size have never gotten those kind of offers that people say, well, look what San Francisco got, or look what Detroit got. I mean, these are metropolitan areas of 5 million people. The metropolitan areas like ours, Memphis and New Orleans, got nothing from their owners. We're getting a $50 million donation, which is also $50 million more than we ever got for any of our previous three arenas.
Rauda also questioning the economic impact that the Thunder have had on the city.
Holt's studies, it was paid for by the chamber, so that it's pretty biased science. But if you actually look at the real numbers, nothing would suggest that we have an uptick in economic activity.
Meanwhile, Holt points to the growth of the city since the team arrived.
Just use your eyes, you know. Like anyone who has lived here for the last 20 years knows the economic explosion that we've experienced, and that the city in 2023 looks nothing like the city did in 2007.
Grant Palmer, Fox 25 News.
So let's break down the proposed funding for the new arena. The $900 million project would be paid for primarily through three funding sources, the first being a temporary 1 cent sales tax lasting 72 months. It would begin after the expiration of the current maps for 1 cent sales tax. The current sales tax rate in Oklahoma City would remain the exact same as it is today. The method of using sales tax shares the overall tax burden with visitors to Oklahoma City. It's estimated that about a quarter of all sales tax in the city is paid by non-OKC residents, and at least $70 million of the funding would come from MAPS 4. That money was previously earmarked for OKC's downtown arena. The owners of the Thunder would also contribute $50 million toward the publicly owned arena.
A series of commercials by the Keep Oklahoma City Big League campaign citing thousands of jobs and millions in economic activity as voters prepare to go to the polls. Take a look.
A new arena is about more than basketball games, rodeos, and concerts. It's about building on the progress of OKC. Arena events create thousands of jobs for families across the city, bringing in more than $500 million to our economy every year. It will keep the Thunder in OKC through 2050 and secure our status for national events without a tax increase. Let's keep OKC's momentum going. On December 12th, vote yes to keep OKC Big League.
And a long list of organizations have endorsed the new arena plan. Just taking a look on the Keep OKC Big League site, a big coalition of groups pledging their support, encouraging voters to say yes on December 12th. They include Allied Arts OKC, Ministry Associations, Boys and Girls Clubs, as well as the Greater Oklahoma City Chamber of Commerce and the Greater Oklahoma City Metro Hotel Association.
The People's Council for Justice Reform is against the new arena. They held a press conference today, voicing their opposition and calling the proposal a taxpayer giveaway to billionaires. Now, that organization listed several reasons for residents to vote against the proposition, arguing it's a bad deal for taxpayers and takes away money that could be spent on major issues in the community, like homelessness.
When you vote to take $1 billion away from our government and from taxpayer money, and you put it into an arena for billionaires, that you're taking money out of the pocket and out of the places where it can do the most good.
Another main focus of those against the deal is the disproportion between what team ownership would contribute versus taxpayers, pointing to the profits brought in by the Thunder as it has grown over 16 seasons. We've got your back, breaking down what that value is. Forbes did a recent value calculation of the Thunder, saying the franchise is worth just over $3 billion. The team was purchased in 2006 for $325 million. That's an increase of over $2.5 billion. In 2023, the team brought in $267 million worth of revenue, with $154 million going to players. The overall operating income for the team last year, $49 million.
Since the Thunder's arrival in 2008, the city's added about 150,000 to its population, and the estimated annual economic impact of the NBA in Oklahoma City, more than $600 million and 3,000 jobs, according to a 2019 study commissioned by the Thunder. Now, since the Thunder came to Oklahoma City, we've also jumped from the 37th largest city in the United States to the 20th largest city. As Oklahoma City residents head to the ballot box and decide the fate of the new arena, we wanted to find out what message Mayor Holt has for both sides of the debate.
Fox 25's David Chasnoff spoke with him this afternoon. David, what did you learn?
Adam and Wendy, Mayor Holt tells me he doesn't just want to win. He wants to show the whole country that the Thunder are here to stay.
I want to show the whole country and the whole world that Oklahoma City has every intention of remaining a big league city, a global city.
As the election gets underway, Mayor Holt wants to remind OKC voters that the Thunder's economic value helped create lots of city resources.
A mental health crisis center, a diversion hub, Palomar Family Justice Center. We weren't doing those things in the 90s. And we won't be doing them again if we take a step back and we become a small town again.
Some people say a new arena isn't necessary when big names like Drake, J. Cole, and Adam Sandler have booked upcoming shows at the Paycom Center. But Mayor Holt challenges people to look beyond those events and see the bigger picture.
The data shows our concerts have gone down over time, and we're losing out to cities that are smaller than ours, like Tulsa. You know, we don't even have the best arena in the state of Oklahoma. That should be, like, offensive to people in Oklahoma City. It's great that we got Drake. I'm excited for that. But there's so many other shows that we didn't get. And that's going to keep happening more and more and more.
He offers a final word to both sides of the new arena debate.
It's just really important that we have a sense of urgency in the next few days, and we understand what's at stake. We've put so much as a community. We didn't come this far just to come this far. We want to keep going. We want to see this renaissance last for another generation, and we have such an amazing opportunity here to do that without even raising taxes.
Mayor Holt says a yes vote will help continue supporting the city's efforts in homelessness and mental health. Reporting live in Oklahoma City, David Chasnoff, Fox 25 News.
Well, tonight we also have insight into a letter a group of professors wrote against the Thunder Arena deal.
Those professors are all from Oklahoma universities and have degrees in economics and finance. Fox 25's Tom Ferguson joins us live now from the Greater OKC Chamber. So, Tom, experts there are pushing back on this?
Adam and Wendy, that's correct. They say the letter got things wrong, as both sides are jogging to make their cases ahead of the big day on Tuesday. The message from the chamber here: keep OKC big league, vote yes on December 12th.
The vote to decide the fate of the current deal for a new Thunder Arena is coming in less than a week. This letter, dated December 4th, argues the numbers don't add up. The head of the economics department at the University of Oklahoma signed on to it.
And some of the statements that are being made that we want to keep the Thunder, we don't want to lose the Thunder, I think a lot of that is just intimidation, and it's just kind of manipulation. There's no reason to feel, in my opinion, that the Thunder will leave Oklahoma City as a knee-jerk reaction to being asked to go back to the bargaining table.
Eric Long, a research economist with the Greater Oklahoma City Chamber, disagrees. He says the city cannot risk losing the Thunder when other markets would be more than happy to take over.
The Oklahoma City Thunder, they have more than 10 million followers internationally on social media. We can't ask for a better partner to provide exposure to the local business community. On December 12th, the residents of Oklahoma City have an incredible opportunity to maintain the momentum that Oklahoma's experienced over the past 30 years.
Under the current deal, taxpayers would fund about 95% of the minimum $900 million arena through a continuation of a penny sales tax. The Thunder ownership group would kick in about $50 million for the publicly owned facility. Detractors call it the worst deal in NBA history.
And we'll have that full letter posted on our website, plus more information from those in favor of the deal. Live in Oklahoma City, Tom Ferguson, Fox 25 News.
Early voting for the proposed arena continues tomorrow from 8 to 6. Election day takes place next Tuesday, December 12th. The county election board and other polling locations. Embark bus and Oklahoma City streetcar services will be free on election day to help get voters to the polls. Many people living in Oklahoma City and are eligible to vote in the arena election, but they just don't realize it because their address or school district is associated with a suburb like Edmond, Mustang, Yukon, or more. So there's a simple way to figure out where you live and if you're looking at your big blue trash bin. If it says Oklahoma City, you live in Oklahoma City. You can also verify where you live by entering your address on OKC.gov. And the State Election Board's online voter tool can help you find your polling place and lets you read the sample ballot.
And that was your big story breakdown tonight. You can find more about the arena vote on OKCFox.com.
And if you miss any part of the big story breakdown, it's all on our YouTube channel. Scan the QR code on your screen or search OKC Fox.